If you are planning to start an ESP drone project, please watch this. You may not want to start. This project is surprisingly one of the offshore projects of Expressive. There was an update a few weeks ago, so the project is suddenly maintained. Since this is an open source project, all the source code is disclosed. Also, hardware information is included, so if you can make a PCB by yourself, you may not need to buy this drone kit. As you can see here, I bought this ESP drone version 1.2 from an open market and assembled it. This one is based on the ESP32S2, but some sellers have drone kits that include the ESP32S3. However, this seems to be a bit more expensive. I bought the cheapest version, which was around 39 bucks. And there is no separate assembly manual, only this image. I think it is not provided separately because it's easy to assemble. But I made a lot of mistakes when I built it. Okay, so let's talk about the pros and cons of this drone kit. As you can see here, the assembly is very intuitive. There are no particular issues during assembly, but the information about the motor connection. The positive and negative connections of the motors were not clear. What's even more interesting is that the cables for two of the motors were white and black, while the other two were red and blue. The image talks about the direction of the propellers, but it does not show how to connect the motors. Eventually, after several attempts, I was able to connect them properly. This is a drone kit I assembled. The red line goes to positive ones, then negative. The white line goes to positive ones, then negative. This will vary depending on the drone kit you have, so please take a look at it as a reference only. Now you can attach the guard that protects the propeller. It is important to raise the motor as high as possible so that the motor propeller and guard do not hit each other. Seems like it's enough. The battery used here is 1-cell lipo battery with a discharge rate of 25C and battery capacity is 400 mAh. This is a typical toy drone battery. To operate four motors at the same time, a lot of current is required. Therefore, when you buy a battery, please calculate the maximum current by calculating the discharge rate and battery capacity. Now that the drone is ready, it's time to prepare the mobile app to control it. The drone operates in Wi-Fi AP mode and connects to this drone via Wi-Fi direct from your mobile phone. After that, all data communication is transmitted as UDP packets. Both iOS and Android apps are available, and I recommend using the Android app because it allows for more detailed settings. For Android apps, you need to download the APK file and install it yourself. For iOS, you can download it directly from the App Store. This model is the most basic one and its functions are limited to basic flight. Since it has an MPU 6050 sensor, it basically collects data for the accelerometers and gyroscope. This is the most basic sensor for a drone, and without it, it would probably be almost impossible to fly a drone. This test is about how the motors that operate depending on the tilt of the drone change. When I intentionally tilt the drone in a certain direction, the motor in the tilted direction does not operate. This is to balance it by forcibly controlling the motor in the direction that is tilted the most. So what if we try to fly it? It's really hard to control it. As I mentioned, it only contains MPU-6050. It seems that stable control is impossible with this. Maybe I'm not good at controlling the drone, but everything doesn't work as I want. What I recommend is not this basic model, but the model that includes a PMW-3901 optical flow sensor so that it can fly stably. It seems very difficult without a stabilizer. I think I need to do some more research on this to use it properly. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.